year since 2001, over 150 families and friends gathered together on Mother's Day morning to raise money for breast cancer research. Our team, Egan's Wings, walks in the honor of Kathy Eagan and the millions of others fighting the battle.
Hi, I'm Kathy Eagan. I am a breast cancer survivor. I was diagnosed in 2000 with stage 4 breast cancer. It has been 13 years and I am still alive because my friends, family, church, doctors, and Susan G. Komen.
Hi, I'm Andrew Eagan and I'm the team captain of Egan's Wings as we participate in Susan G. Komen's Race for the Cure. We walk because there, 1 out of every 8 women will be diagnosed with breast cancer in their lifetime. We walk for our grandmas, our moms, our sisters, our friends, and our family, so no one will ever have to hear the words, "You have breast cancer." Last year, Egan's Wings was able to raise over $5,000 for Susan G. Komen, and 75% of that stayed right here in Minnesota, and 25% of it went nationally to grants and research for leading edge breast cancer discoveries.
Hi, I'm Lynn, and I was thinking about the first time that I participated in the Race for the Cure, and that was in 2001. Because of Kathy Eagan, and she is so loved and supported by so many people, and I just wanted to be a part of that. It's such a special thing.
I participate in Race for the Cure because my grandmother was a cancer survivor, and also my sister-in-law's mom. And after we moved to Minneapolis, we started participating for Kathy on Egan's Wings. It's really special to be part of that team because Egan's Wings has so much positive energy, so many neighbors and friends coming together in support of Kathy, and also others in their families, other friends. It's just a beautiful thing to be a part of.
We first walked in Race for the Cure back in 1997. We lived in Iowa, and I had a job with a factory there. So there was all kinds of opportunities to contribute back to the community and everything, but I never saw an organization like Race for the Cure that managed to get the whole community's participation and turn it into a great, big, wholesome, family-oriented event where everybody could participate together for a good cause. And that got us hooked. And then, as Peggy says, when we moved up here, and it actually hit home because someone in our neighborhood, someone who went to our church, someone who was a good friend of ours, was directly impacted. And after that, many others have been. But Race for the Cure was a very focused and very wholesome, family-oriented event that we can all throw our support behind.
I started doing Race for the Cure many, many years ago when it was at Southdale. And as a competitive runner, I love to run races that have a cause with them. And so I started doing Race for the Cure and loved the atmosphere, loved the people, just everything about it. And then when Kathy was diagnosed with cancer and she formed the Egan's Wings team, it gave even more meaning to being a part of Race for the Cure.
And I do Race for the Cure for many of the same reasons that Bonnie said. I like it because it's a great cause. The money goes to the Komen Foundation. They're helping look for a cure for breast cancer. And we all know people in our lives, Kathy being one of them, have been affected by breast cancer, and hopefully their research in the area of breast cancer will lead to a cure for that disease and also lead to a cure for other types of cancer.
Egan's Wings was formed 13 years ago with just 15 people, and today we have over 150 people who join us every year.
Join us for Race for the Cure this year.
Join us for the walk.
Join us.
Join us.
Join us.
Join us.
Join us.
Join the Egan's Wings team for the Susan G. Komen Race for the Cure Walk on May 12th. Looking forward to seeing you there.
Every second counts on the clock that's ticking. Gotta live like we're dying. We got 86, 400 seconds in a day to turn it all around or to throw it all away. Gotta tell them that we love them while we got the chance to say. Gotta live like we're dying. Careful.